lethal force by law enforcement will not be tolerated any longer. We cannot let the POA think they can bully San Francisco, California, and anyone into believing that they control and run our city. Bullying people will not be accepted. So we want to send a message clear, not only to Mayor Lee, to the POA. If you continue to bully politicians, you continue to lobby against the people, your day is a number of us left. This is serious business. These officers who shot and executed Mario Wallace need to be prosecuted. We don't need to wait for the DOJ to come here and investigate. We are people. We have our own side for the law, and we investigate. We find out what's really going on with the San Francisco County Department.
One mind. We don't want to be disheartened. We don't want to give them a reason
grown up to this point. We thank Occupy. We thank all of the last 3%, Black Lives Matter, all the movements that is making sure that this is kept in front so the world would know that we seek justice here in San Francisco. And as you can see, over the years, they never want this to go nationwide. We've been calling on the Department of Justice to come into San Francisco and investigate the SFPD for literally 15 years. There's been many reports. There have been many studies. But for some reason, we have a use of force. Department of General Orders that have remained in place for over 20 years. That's not by an accident. That means that this department, this police commission, this city, refuse to recognize the will of the people. And after we finish with San Francisco, we must pay a visit to the state of California. Because up in the state, the police have a thing called the Bill of Rights, Police Bill of Rights.
Yeah.
Do you know that they do not have to answer to the same call that we answer to? If any one of you has shot someone 25 times, you would be in jail or under the jail. But when a police officer shoots and kills someone and executes someone, the police bill of rights kick in. So these are the type of things that we must lobby all our state representatives, that we must change and amend or just totally appear. I'm going to pass it on, Johnny. Speak on other issues. Once again, be proud of yourself. Justice for Mario Wood.
With us for Justice for Mario Rose. We're also marching for Justice for Alex Nieto. Amilcar Lopez. We have buttons that we're passing around. But I also want to let you know that we've got security here for us. And I don't know where the rest of the security are. They'll be wearing buttons. If you see anything out of the ordinary, please let one of them know so they can handle it. All right? And I'm going to pass it on to
history, all throughout this country's history, this has been happening. It's been happening since the 13th Amendment, which so-called freed the slaves, but the clause was, unless they commit a crime, which included stepping on a white man's shadow. So all throughout history, they have been accusing us. And if you look at how many white people have been convicted of killing a black man, you will see that all the way up into the 1950s and 60s, there was like three men who were convicted, but black men were being killed all the time. So the first police officers were slave patrol. Research it. The first police officers were the church slaves. And if you understand that, the history of law enforcement up until today has been to terrorize black people. And if you know the prison industrial complex system, you know that they make money off of black bodies just like they did in slavery. They put, back in the day, they would arrest people for fake charges and put them on the chain gang. And they will have the right to kill you and get away with it. And you can't say this is something new, because 20 years ago, on video, you saw Rodney King get beat, and all five of the cops got acquitted. Every single cop was innocent. So if you look at today, because of social media and technology, you can see that it happens all the time, but this is not new. Black people have been going through this from the beginning of this country's creation. I'm born and raised in San Francisco, and ever since I was a little kid, cops have been harassing me. I got handcuffed the first time when I was 11 years old by a grown cop. Manhandled me and arrested me. 11 years old. And every day I would have to give a fake name, because if you give your real name, you get put in the system even if you didn't commit a crime. So after a while, you become a suspect or a gang member just because they stop you and they have your name charted in the system for a certain amount of time. So as a kid, I had to lose my identity and give a fake name in order to survive. So I couldn't even have my own identity because I had to protect myself from being wrongfully incriminated. If you see every week another black man is exonerated, the word exonerate means to be wrongfully put in jail and then found innocent and then released. So after 40 years of spending in jail, every week another black man is released because he was innocent. He doesn't get that time back. And that's people who've been to prison. But all the men who have died, they'll never get their life back, ever. And they were died, they were killed wrongfully. You can believe whatever you like, you can call them a criminal, you can call them whatever they like, we're all human beings. We all deserve to live, we all deserve happiness. You see manifested before you is the result of a dream. That means someone has to think about a situation for it to come true. That is why this is happening today. This government planned for it to be exactly the way it is. And thank God for technology, because black people, we have been complaining. We have been trying to inform people and educate people, but nobody wants to listen to us. To this day, people are against our movement because they're ignorant to the history, because the books that you receive in school are written by the conquerors. They're not written by the people who've been conquered. So would you listen to a Chinese person tell the history of an Iraqi person? No. Would you listen to a white person tell the history of a black person? So if you want to learn the history of black people, you should learn it from black people. Just like I want to learn the history from white people, I'm going to go to a white man to learn that history. And you should learn everybody's history because we're all human. But just make sure you're learning that history from the correct mouth. Because if you're learning it from someone who's not for the people, it's a false story, exactly. And it's the same goes for the Native Americans. Black people aren't the only ones getting killed by the police. Native Americans in the reservations are being killed all the time. And it's been happening since the beginning. So this is either going to stop
all the people. Peace.
Well said. Do you have anyone else?
Hi, everybody. My name is Nancy Cotto. I'm here to be a social party. It's great to see so many people out here. I, like you all, are so pissed off about what's been going on in this city, from kicking people out of their homes to making it unaffordable, to having no jobs, to having no services for homeless people. We also think that it's important when we talk about policing the cops, we don't leave it them to do it. Instead, what we need to be talking about is how the elected civilian police board under community control, so that we get to decide, you know, and do the justice. Because the cops are the ones who are going crazy on us because they are racist, they're sexist, they're homophobic, and they're a bunch of pigs, basically.
Up to the words of
Leslie to make him not just, as he said at the inauguration, judge him by his words, but by his what? His actions, his deeds. And we're here today to take action. There's been years of community collaboration to reform the police department. And I just want to say one more thing. I was in North Beach and I talked to a couple cops. One of them actually was raised in San Francisco, and he said, you know, I used to say fuck the pig. A police officer who was raised in San Francisco. And I asked him, do you think that the murder of Mario Woods was justified? Do you think that using guns was justified for those police officers? And they said, go look to the code. It's actually protected. We're protected by 5.02, the police code. Whenever we want to use force because we feel like it's been escalated, we can. How many of those police officers were actually trained in crisis intervention training? 4 out of 5. So it's not working. We need to reform the police department. I stand with the people of Justice for Mario Woods in demanding what they are demanding, which is what? Number one, we need a replacement. We need to think of a replacement. Number two, charge the officer with murder. Look at that 5.02 code, and we have to reform it. And number three, independent investigation, which you've won by your hard work already. You're working. It's close. Talk to that, because I was sure about that. But thank you all for coming out here today. I'm glad to stand in solidarity with everyone.
That the independent investigation just doesn't require a request to the DOJ. No, Justice for Mario Woods Coalition, we're going to give more thought to this. Because for one, how are you going to bypass all of the state politicians and just go straight to Washington? There's Kamala Harris. There's Governor Brown. There's Lieutenant Governor Gavin Newsom. And all of them going to be running, continue to run for office. They need to be put on the carpet. They have to come and answer to the community also. Senator Dianne Feinstein, Congresswoman Nancy Pelosi, they are not exempt. They are not exempt from what is going on in our city around the murder, the execution by firing squad of Mario Woods. And so we continue to stand, we continue to march, we continue to invite and change the laws of justice around Mario Woods and Alex Nieto and Amilcar Lopez. And so we're getting ready to start. And so we have posters. We want everyone to have a poster. So raise your hand if you don't have a poster so we can get them to you. Raise your hand. Okay, brothers.
Thank you. policy. 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 Policy.
They will not win! Yeah. What's up, gang?
How you doing? Good to see you.
You gang of two?
You good? If you make your way into the Super Bowl city, be mindful that there's certain materials that can't be taken into the Super Bowl city. And be mindful of your own safety. We have made our statement here today. Our statement, again, was to make it clear that this issue will not die until we get justice.
Yeah.
And we want to reiterate that we're not here for anything other than justice for Mario Woods and justice for all of those who have been killed by law enforcement here in San Francisco.
Yeah.
We are people. This is a people protest. And please be reminded, we have a right to protest. As citizens of the United States of America.
Yeah.
So let us turn in the west direction and let's take our energy and continue to protest, continue to shout, continue to encourage each other. Because this is a movement. This is not a sprint, it's a marathon.
Yeah.
For justice.
Yeah.
Are you with me?
Yeah.
Are you with me?
Yes.
Justice.
For Mario Woods.
Thank you.
Justice. Now. Justice. Now. Justice.